Hey guys, it's tax season again, and I am back with 2023's video for what is the best online tax software for this year. This year, I'm gonna be comparing TurboTax, H&RBlock.com, and FreeTaxUSA. Later on in the season, I am planning to review Cash App taxes, but it is not out yet, so I will add in a separate review for that one later. Before we get into what's the difference between these different software, let's talk about what they have in common. They are all authorized by the IRS e-file system, which means they all have to pass the same security test, and they all have to prepare an accurate tax return. Keep in mind that tax software really is just like a big calculator. It takes your numbers that you put in, it crunches them through the formulas of the tax code, and it spits out an answer for how much your refund should be this year. So as long as you're putting in the same numbers and the calculator works, you should get the same answer out the other side. The only real difference between the different software is the type of interface, how helpful it is to help you figure out what numbers you need to be putting in, and how much it costs. And there is a big difference in cost with these different software. They're all going to walk you through basic questions about your family, your basic information. Oh, and just a reminder, I am using completely fake people that I've been using for multiple years. It is all fake information, fake social security numbers. Don't worry, it's not my info. TurboTax and H&R Block do have prettier interfaces and they have lots of images. After getting through the beginning part, TurboTax is also trying to sell me an upgrade. Their free version is good for a lot of people, but even with the free version, they're gonna try to sell you this plus package for an extra $29. It's really not necessary if you qualify for their free version. You notice this spinning wheel? TurboTax and H&R Block both have this. Every time you're going to a new section, it spins and loads and takes forever. I don't know why both of them are so stinking slow. In contrast, here's FreeTaxUSA, and I fill out my information and I click save and continue. And it goes right there. There's no loading time. FreeTaxUSA does try to sell you their version of Deluxe, and it's $7.99, which is much less expensive than the other ones, but also not necessary. H&R Block is also constantly popping up this little box asking if you want to chat with a tax pro. And again, that's going to cost you money. The interface on TurboTax is nice and pretty to look at, and it has the menu down the side. But I do feel like you have to kind of dig around a lot to find all the different things. One thing I like about FreeTaxUSA is that their menus are very clear and easy to use. You can see all the different kinds of income right here, and you can also skip around really easily to get to those different sections. H&R Block also has nice, pretty menus, but they have the problem too of a lot of things are pretty hidden. You can't even get to the different income sections. You would have to go into this income profile to find other areas. So let's look at what adding a W-2 would look like on all three of these options. So in TurboTax, we're gonna click to add a W-2, and it'll give you multiple options for getting your W-2 in. You can upload it from your computer, you can take a picture with your phone, or you can type it in manually. They used to, in the past, have an option to also get it directly from your employer. I'm not seeing that yet. I'm not sure if that might be coming back later. If you click to type it in yourself, TurboTax has actually improved this form. I like that it's only two pages to get everything entered for your W-2, so it's pretty easy to use. In H&R Block, the system's pretty similar. Right now, they only have the manual entry options on H&R Block, but in past years, they have added more options later, like uploading a PDF. I do like that H&R Block puts all the W-2 information on one page, so you can enter it all at once, and then you just click continue once at the bottom. On FreeTaxUSA, we're gonna click add a W-2. In the past, I've had no upload options, but they did add an upload beta this year. I haven't tried it yet, but I'm pretty excited that they're finally adding those options, but we'll see what it looks like when you enter it manually. You see FreeTaxUSA keeps it very simple, all one page, very clear. I actually prefer their interface because I feel like it's just simple and easy. So let's look at adding other kinds of forms. 1099 INT for bank interest is a really common one, so let's look at that one. It takes a while to get to the right menus in TurboTax, and once you're there, it's going to encourage you to download your information straight from your bank. I think this is sort of a fancy feature that TurboTax has, but for most people with pretty simple forms, this is way overkill and pretty unnecessary in my opinion. So I would generally choose to enter it manually. And when you go in to enter it manually, it still gives you more options of you can bring it in from the bank, you can upload it as a PDF, or you can type it in. Once you do finally get to the type in box on TurboTax, it actually is a really nice page. It's very simple. It's only asking you to fill out a couple boxes. I kind of wish it just took me straight there. Let's look at H&R Block. Theirs is a little bit simpler in that I didn't have to go through so many menus to get here. One thing I don't like about H&R Block for the 1099 INT is that they are giving you all the boxes, and almost everyone is only gonna have box one, maybe box three filled in. So it's really unnecessary that they're showing you all these boxes, but it is still a pretty simple page. On FreeTaxUSA, I got to this page just by clicking on income, interest income, 1099 INT. No big series of menus. And then it just gives you the simple page where you can put everything in. This, like H&R Block, does give you all the boxes, so it is more than necessary, just like H&R Block though. Now let's look at support available if you need some help. On TurboTax, you do have this option right here to click for help, and it gives you lots of different written information. Over here, you can click live tax advice. And of course, with TurboTax, to get the live tax advice, you have to upgrade. H&R Block has pretty similar systems. You can get just written information for free. If you want a real person, you have to upgrade for $40. On FreeTaxUSA, they have, I love these little question marks they have next to everything. And it'll explain every single box on the form if you have any questions about it. It's actually better written information, I feel like, than TurboTax or H&R Block. If you do need support from a person, you can actually send an email to support for free, even with the free version of FreeTaxUSA. If you want live support, you do have to upgrade. I also like this little feature they have called Where Do I Enter? And it gives you a list of all the different possible forms you could have, and you can click right on it and it'll tell you exactly where you need to enter it. And you can even click the link and it'll take you straight to the page. So let's take a quick look comparing the costs of these three software options. TurboTax, if you do qualify for the free edition, it is 100% free for federal and state. But as we talked about, you have to avoid all their different upgrade options and stay on the free track with that one. It gets quite expensive if you move up even just to the deluxe option. It's on sale for $39, but regularly $59. And then you have to pay for the state, which is an additional $39 or regular $54. It ends up over $100 just to move up one step. And it gets really expensive if you get up into their highest version. H&R Block pricing is pretty similar to TurboTax. They also have a completely free version, free federal, free state. And with H&R Block, just like TurboTax, your state is additional once you move up into those higher ones. So even their lowest ends up pretty close to $100. With FreeTaxUSA, their federal returns are 100% free, all forms, all situations. But there is a charge for state returns. It's $14.99 for state. So if you're somebody that qualifies for the completely free version of H&R Block or TurboTax, I think that's a decent way to go. I used to use TurboTax every year. I thought it was the right thing to do, and I was paying over $100 every year to use TurboTax until I learned about FreeTaxUSA, and I started using it for myself, and I even helped my parents use it as well. I love that I know I'll be done quickly and easily, and it will not cost me more than $15. If you decide you wanna use FreeTaxUSA, I do have my affiliate link down below in the top comment. I'd really appreciate if you use that, and I do make a commission if you use that link and you spend any money on FreeTaxUSA. I became an affiliate for FreeTaxUSA because I really do like it. I actually prefer to use it over TurboTax. If you are filing taxes for the very first time and you have a really simple return, I do have a full walkthrough of how to use TurboTax Free Edition. I show everything step by step on how to get your taxes filed for your very first time. I'm gonna leave that link right here. Please watch that one next if you wanna see a full walkthrough of how to use TurboTax for the very first time.